Hello, what is up, guys? Eman from PesoSmart PH here. Welcome to a new episode. Shout out to all the podcast listeners as well. I appreciate you all. Today, we're gonna talk about GMA7. Right, so nito tayo sa chart ng GMA7. Ginagamit ko yung Investagram. So, kanina nag-close siya at around 13 pesos and 50 centavos. So, yung open, 13.70. Lowest was 13.50. Yun na din yung close niya. And then, the highest was around 13.86 pesos per share. Yung volume is around 1.63 million, yung total value niyan is around 22.35 million pesos. Yung market cap niya is currently sitting at 45.37 billion pesos. So yung volume is hindi ganun kataas, no? Yung trades nga is around 851 trades lang. So in comparison dito, yun, yung August 17 medyo mataas yung kanyang trading volume. Pero ngayon hindi masyado. Kailan yung huling mataas? Nandito. Kailan ba to? June 23 and June 22. Then, pinakamataas is back nung March 29. Doon talaga nag-start, no? Yung like pagtaas niya. Kasi dito, nag-announce ng dividends itong GMA7. And then, syempre dito, after nung ex-date, bumagsak ulit siya. So, dito, pinakamagandang like bumili, no? Itong stock na ito. And then, ngayon, like, talaga nag-skyrocket na siya. Actually, dito, bumili ulit ako, eh. Nung nag-dip. So, around 12-ish, 11 point something pesos. Bumili ulit ako ng konting GMA7 to add to my portfolio. So, okay naman, no? Kasi ngayon, naka-recover na ulit siya. Nasa 13 level na ulit siya. So, parang yun yung support ulit. Nasa 13 level. Ngayon, pwede tayong pumunta sa weekly na time frame. So, ito yung naka-open sa akin is 20-week MA and 21-week EMA. So, yan. Nasa taas naman tayo, ano? So, kumbaga, nagbo-bull run lang siya. And then, I think, magkoconsolidate lang naman siya dito for a couple of months, I believe. And then, we'll see kung magkakaroon ng catalyst na tumaas ulit, no? Kung like, tataas ulit yung demand para dun sa stock. Magkakaroon ba ng good news, magandang sentiment for GMA7? Magiging okay na ba yung Philippines like versus COVID? So, yun yung mga parang macroeconomical factors na makaka-apekto sa stock prices ng GMA7. And then, especially yung kanilang financial statement. So, nilabas na rin naman yun, pero hindi ganun kalaki yung impact nung financial statements na yun sa kanilang stock prices. Kasi, I think a lot of people, or like almost everyone who's also holding GMA7 stocks, are expecting na ganun yung maging performance nila sa second quarter ng 2021. And I think ang magiging malaking catalyst na lang din sa pagtaas lalo ng stock prices ng GMA7 is pag nag-announce sila ng dividend sila, which is gonna be next year pa. Pero kapag ka nagbigay sila ng bonus na dividends for this particular year, this year, like nagbigay sila ng special dividends, I mean, that will take GMA7 to the moon. And I might have to consider like selling some to take some profits if ever that happens. Pero if hindi, kung next year lang ulit sila magbigay ng dividends and mag-announce, then I'm not gonna sell. I'm just gonna take all the dividends that I can get from this stock. Now, PSC Edge naman tayo. So, yung 52-week high niya is around 14.88. Nakuha yon noong June. Around June 30. So, 14.88, no? Actually, that was a good time to sell a bit. And then like nag-re-enter dito. But of course, sobrang hirap naman tayo mga nung market. So if you were able to do that, then good for you. Pero ako, hindi ako nagbenta kasi I'm a bit stubborn. Sabi ko, hindi, magbebenta ako at around 15-16 pesos per share. Actually, nagkaroon ako ng sell order at that time at around 15 or 15.5. I can't really remember kung ano yung taong figures. Pero yun yung range na gusto ko mag-sell, no? And then sabi ko, sige, mag-re-enter na ako pagka bumaba ulit or pag nagkaroon ng correction. But hindi naabot yung aking target price, so wala akong nabenta. And then yung 52-week low niya, so lowest in 1 year is around 4.90 pesos per share. That was back in October pa, I believe. Yes, October 7, 4.19 lowest. So medyo matagal na, no? And I believe hindi na siya babalik sa ganung prices. Unless like bumalik yung GMA7, mabigyan ulit sila ng franchise and then like, you know, mahati ulit, no, yung income ng GMA7. And as I've said earlier, nag-release na ng kanilang quarterly financial report ng GMA7. So let's review it. So yan, for the period ended June 30, 2021. So yung currency is PHP obviously, and then wala tayong kailangang i-add na zero. So we're gonna read the figures here as it is. So yung kanilang retained earnings is around 4.2 billion pesos na. Last year, it was around 7.2 billion pesos yung naging retained earnings nila for the whole year. So more than half na, no, yung nakukuhang retained earnings for this particular year. So for the first 6 months of 2021, kanilang gross revenue for the second quarter is 5.1 billion pesos. Gross expenses is around 3 billion pesos. Yung kanilang net income before taxes is 2 billion. And then after taxes, 1.6 billion pesos yan. The previous year, yung kanilang net income after taxes is around 824.6 million pesos. So, ang laking difference, no? So, almost 1 billion yung na-increase sa kanilang net income after taxes. Current year to date, this is like the first 6 months, no? So, 3.6 billion pesos yung kanilang kinita. Last year, in comparison, 1.4 billion pesos pa lang for the first 6 months of 2020. Now, if gusto nyo ng in-depth na file or na disclosure, click nyo lang to, no, itong quarterly report. So, punta kayo sa company disclosures, click nyo yung quarterly report ng GMA7 or like ng kahit anong stock na gusto nyo i-review, and then i-download nyo yung PDF file ng kanilang full financial statement. Ito ngayon, so pasadahan natin, no. So hindi ko like iisa-isa yung lahat, no? Kasi like abutin tayo ng sham-sham dito. So yung mga highlights lang yung ipapakita ko sa inyo, and yeah, siguro parang kumbaga summary na lang din, no, nitong kanilang financial report. Yung full financial report nila. So yan, GMA Network Incorporated and subsidiaries remained at the forefront of the broadcast industry, ceiling first half of this year with consolidated revenue surpassing 10 billion pesos. Ang laki ng kanilang kinita. Well, revenues pa lang naman to. And obviously, nagawa nila to kasi wala yung kanilang biggest competitor, which is ABS-CBN. So income data nila, yung revenue. So, advertising revenue nila is around 9.8 billion pesos na, no? So, 61% increase yan compared to last year. 6.1 billion pesos lang yung last year. Then, sa consumer sales of services is around 454 million pesos. So, down yan ng 14% compared to last year. Sale of goods naman is tumaas din by 236%, nasa 256.5 million pesos na yung kanilang sale of goods for the first 6 months of 2021. And then yung total operating expenses is 5.9. Tumaas yan ng 25% compared to last year. Net income nila, nakita na rin natin kanina dun sa summary ng financial statement nila sa PSE Edge, 3.6 billion pesos. And ito, cementing first 6 months results this 2021, consolidated advertising revenue soared to 9.8 billion pesos. Again, billion to, no? Kasi, di ba? Ito, pagka binasa mo to as it is, it's 9,800. Pero may million dito. So, imumultiply mo siya sa 1 million or magdadagdag ka ng 6 zero. So, that's gonna be 9.8 billion. A huge 61% higher than a year ago. All airtime revenue generated platforms yielded upbeat sales results versus the same period last year. Sale of goods further boosted the top line of the company owing to the successful launch of the GMA Afford the Box in the middle of last year and GMA Now towards year end of 2020. Meanwhile, sale of services, which included subscriptions, income, subsidiaries, operations, and others, concluded the first semester down 14%, contracting by 75 million pesos. From 529 million pesos to 455 million pesos. Then, ito yung kanilang production costs, no? So, yung total talent fee na binayaran nila is 1.1 billion pesos. Ang laki, no? Well, ang dami naman nilang artists, so ang dami nilang talent, so ang dami nilang kailangan bayaran. So, up yan or tumaas yan ng 22% compared to last year. Then yung rentals and outside services, around 148 million pesos. And other program expenses is around 429.5 million pesos. So subtotal niyan, Cash production costs 1.6 billion pesos. And then program rights amortization 482 million, depreciation and amortization 72 million pesos. So subtotal non-cash production cost 555 million pesos yan, and total production cost nila for the first 6 months of 2021 is 2.2 billion pesos. Nag-increase din yan ng konti, no? 22% compared to last year. Then we have here the general and administrative expenses. So kasama yung personnel cost, outside services, facilities cost, taxes and licenses, and others. So in total niyan is 3.2 billion pesos. Then yung non-cash, depreciation and amortization, provision for doubtful accounts, amortization of software costs, nasa in total niyan is around 221 million pesos for a total GAEX of 3.4 billion pesos. Then now we have yung kanilang cash flow. So net cash provided by used in operating activities. So nasa 3.5 billion pesos yan. Net cash used in investing activities, negative 457 million. Net cash used in financing activities, negative 2.6 billion. Effect of exchange rate changes on cash and cash equivalents, negative 79.94 million. Then yung net increase or decrease in cash and cash equivalents, so increase to kasi positive 293 million. And then yung cash and cash equivalents at beginning of the year is 3.2 billion pesos. Then yung total cash and cash equivalents at the end of this particular period, nasa 3.5 billion pesos yan. So basahin din natin tong kanilang investing activities, no. So ito yung pinagamitan ng 457 million pesos na yon. So this coming primarily from the 436 million additions to property and equipment, and then 48 million acquisition of land. These were partly offset by the 50 million proceeds from property sales. Then financing activities, yung net cash used in financing activities amounted to 2.6 billion pesos, basically due to the payment of and cash dividends and loans amounting to 6.5 billion pesos and 721 million pesos respectively. Partially evened out by the availments of short-term loans totaling 4.5 billion pesos as of end June 2021. Then ito yung last part na i-discuss natin, key financial performance indicators. So ito medyo basic na lang to, yung revenues, advertising rev, cash operating expenses, EBITDA, net income before taxes, and net income after taxes. Actually halos lahat yan is makikita nyo dun sa summary dun sa PSC Edge. Pero ito, yung key performance indicators. Yung current ratio nila is 1.8, asset to equity ratio 2.5, debt to equity ratio is 0.46. So halos wala silang utang, no? Then yung interest rate coverage ratio 2.87, gross profit margin is 77%, gross profit margin, gross yan, no? Then EBITDA margin is 52%, then yung net income margin nila is 35%, mataas yan guys, mataas yan. And then kita nyo naman kapag kakinumpare nyo to last year, net income margin nila is nasa 21%. EBITDA 39%, then yung gross profit margin is almost same lang, 72% compared to 77% this year for the first 6 months. And again, if gusto nyo makita, no, yung full report, i-download nyo lang, punta kayo sa company disclosure ng GMA7, makikita nyo yun yung quarterly report. Mapupunta kayo dito sa page na to or sa window na to. Yan, click nyo lang to, no? Itong August 17, 2021, GMA17Q2Q2021. So, tas click nyo yung download, may file kayo, may PDF file kayo ma-download, then ma-access nyo na yung full report nila, full quarterly report. And then dito may summary din, no? Pag nag-scroll down kayo, makikita nyo dito yung mga basic, yung balance sheet, income statement, which is nandun na rin naman sa, ano, sa financial statement page ng GMA7 sa PSC Edge. Pero yan, makikita nyo dito like yung ibang detalye. Pero same thing lang din yun, para talaga ma-deep dive nyo yung isang financial statement, kailangan nyo i-download no, yung file na mismong sinubmit ng kumpanya sa PSE. Okay guys, that's gonna be it for this episode. Sana may natutunan kayo, and if umabot kayo at the end of this video, thank you very much, I appreciate you. Help me grow the channel by smashing the like button, that really helps with the YouTube algorithm. If you're new, Click nyo na yung subscribe button and ring the notification bell so that you won't miss out on my uploads every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Follow me on my social media platforms at MNPSPH. I'm on TikTok, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Another way to support the channel and become a part of the PesoSmart PH community is through the YouTube membership. Click mo lang yung link dyan sa description sa baba to know more about it. Thanks again for watching and listening, everyone. Stay safe. I'll see you all in the next episode. Always remember, be PesoSmart.